And I see you, and welcome, episode of Space Engineers. In this episode, take a look at the Mailbox by Ulof the Seeker, the Barbette cargo container by Harbinger Ace, the large iron thruster GR910 by Maxime, as well as the burn panels by Axel 2. So first, the Mailbox. So first, you see here, the Mailbox is literally just a mailbox. And that's it. It would be nice if this little thing was animated. That'd be cool. Like here. Yeah. Okay. Not sure what's happening there. You see, the mailbox is right here, and it has the same cargo capacity as a small ship, small container. Not a lot. But only that, this will only accept the data panels, pads. Oh yeah. About that. That was for those nodes that are currently collecting resources. The reason why all this is. And all that stuff. My stuff around this keeps moving. Wait, what's my name? Yeah. Either way, no point. See? It's just this and. Bunk, put that there. You can also put credits in there. So, if I were to ATM, I haven't got one down, plop you somewhere, that will do. I go into this, I put in, let's say, 1,000, withdraw. Now that's in my inventory. I can slap that in there, and there you go. Deliver credits. Now, if we try delivering something else, it won't go in. As you can see, it would help if I actually use things that would actually go through small the conveyors. This lot can't. This can, but it doesn't go in. And this can, it still doesn't go in. And this can be stored, but doesn't go in. That's all it accepts. Which is, whoops. Yeah, so you find those ones. Just need to get platinum. Anywho, I move you back out, and then move you back out. And then shuffle this around. So, yeah. That's that. Maybe put that up to 1,000. As for its build cost, I think it is actually pretty cheap. At only 2. Steel plates, 2 girders, and 3 construction components. That's all it really takes. Though, with the animation engine, I think it could be improved having this, like, down, when there's nothing in it, but since players put something inside of it, it goes up. But isn't that what that thing is actually meant to mean? Like, when it's down, it's empty, and it gets put up when there's actually something in there? I don't know, I've never seen mailboxes like this in real life. I've always had the letterboxes on the doors. Yeah, that's just that. Next, we move on to the. Whoops, did we delete that one? Move on to the container. Which is an interesting little thing, which you actually walk through. And it has conveyor ports on the top and the bottom, so that you can easily slot it in somewhere. Or even stack them if you want. It's a shame they can't be put side to side, but oh well, never mind. Has a total capacity of 140,000, which I think is equal to vanilla large. I'll just have to find where the bugger is under here. They should make a proper place for it. Ooh, there we go. Hey, not quite. It's still more than a small, but not as much as a big. But I guess if you stack 3 of these on top of each other, that's the one. Wait. It'd be the same as a bit large. Hmm. So yeah, it's a great way to store items while still having a way to walk through. And as you see, I could access that, the way to get inside of it. So you can actually take a look at what items are in there. There's other mods that do something similar to this, but I do think this one looks pretty good. Drop panels. What if we can actually put LCDs on these sort of blocks. Right, as far as build cost, I think it doesn't cost too much. Ooh, a lot of different items. About 1,800 steel plates, 180 interior components, 120 construction components, not interior plates, about 460 metal grids, 50 small steel tubes, 8 motors, 2 displays, 2 computers, and that's everything. You're not too bad. Or a bit of a commissioned work. And yeah, if you want to, you can stack them. Make a giant tower out of the buggers. I didn't figure out how to access them. Would be easy enough just by using the little catwalks. One like that. And then you can have that one like that. Then you can have another one like that. And then another one like that. Then I guess you just like do that there. Put that there. And oh, that's how you get up. And do that all the way around until you get to the top. Yeah, that's what you could do. Have a tower. Anyway, that's all there is to really show about this container. As well as the way you can recover it. Just put it on the top. But just because the top and the bottom and some of the interiors. Just nothing inside here. Wait, how about we move on to the thruster? Which is this fancy little thing. An iron thruster works best in space. With a flat panel there, which is probably the intended mount point. It does have mount points on the... Is it at the top and bottom? Let's do a quick check. Yeah. I think these are actually meant to be the sides. If you look at the icon. Yeah, it does have a map point there. Or there. Just there. And there's one on the sides. So you can stick these next to each other if you wanted to. Ah. It even has a... images on the side. Cool. Nice. Anyway. As for the power... I said it's actually open for it. It consumes 69.6 megawatts and puts out a force of 9.72 meganewtons. In comparison to the large vanilla, which is already somewhere, pretty far. And they're really gonna put it on here. That's what I did. Well, there it is. Yeah, which is makes it stronger and more, it consumes more energy than the vanilla one does. See, this is at 4.32 meganewtons of force at 33.6 megawatts max power. So, it is pretty good. Wait a minute, uses up more than twice the power. I think it's twice its power for twice the force. Yeah, so it's kind of balanced. Saves space. Instead of having two large vanillas, you just have one of these. It's allowing you to have a much smaller footprint on the back of your ship for forward thrust. So, why don't we head down to the test chamber to see the thruster pushing at full power. I discovered this thing has a bigger footprint than the vanilla. Its base is a 4x4 rather than a 2x3. It will take a bit more space. Still looks cool though. So anyway, how about we go ahead, turn off the lights, turn on the alarm, and activate the thruster. Why do light is any difference? Shiny. Well, that's not how it's supposed to be. Huh. That's boring. Oh well, never mind. Let's power it down. I see there's a little bit of a flame there.
stopped.
Oh, it's going down. Slowly. And it should be offline now. Here we go. So yeah, that wasn't as exciting as I thought it would be. I was expecting a much larger flame. Oh well, never mind. So yeah, that's the thruster. How about we head back upstairs and take a look at the... I should stop in a moment. I might have to stop it manually. And stop. There you go. Open the bottom panel over there. Later. So yeah, that's thruster. Let's go up and take a look at the buttons. And we, here we have the button panels by Exult 2. As you can see, there are four groups of them. I tell from the hotbar here. Which basically has the same 9 buttons, but in 3 mean different configurations. First, you have the one that's on the front of a block. So you got the full screen with 2 buttons. Then you got the one that's just 4 buttons. It looks like there's 4 buttons, but with handles. And this one here, that's got a screen and 4 buttons. It's got a screen and 6 buttons. That's just 9. And that's also 9, but with handles. That's 11 of them, with handles. And this is just a single screen with 12 buttons on it. That's a lot of buttons! What can you even do with all 12? Something. Quite handy in the ship. Especially with that mod that lets you press buttons while you're sat in a pilot seat. Ooh, that'd be a great combination. But yeah, these are basically on the front of a block. These ones are completely flat and are designed to be placed on top of something. Or on the side panel or something like that. So you just add it to an existing build. Like if I was to do this, I could add it to one of these. And yeah, I already have some over there. I could actually just get whichever one of these I need, depending on how many buttons are required, in order to improve it. Yeah, this one needs 3, so the one with 4 buttons will do just fine. Not only that, if I do one with a screen, I can use that screen to monitor how much energy it has available to it and how long its fuel will last. It's pretty handy. So maybe like that one. But that one doesn't tell you how long it's going to last. Oh well, I mean. You see over here, it's the same things but round. That's what the screens look like when they don't have anything on them. You click on them, select what you want, and then there you go. Even the buttons right here. You can name them. So you can have them whatever angle you need. I'll probably use one of these angled ones here. You know, just so it fits in a bit better. As for these ones, I do believe this one is supposed to activate a door. So if I had something, menu. Get Foxtrot. Here you go, Foxtrot. So I will be able to replace this thing. And one of these panels is a slab with this piece. Thus allowing it to melt it a bit better and be a proper door. You get bends. Something. Yeah, they're currently slabs. They're embedded buttons. Be helpful for a variety of different things, depending on what you're really after. And that's basically it. Not really much else to go over, other than the build cost. 10 interior plates, 20 construction components, and 20 computers for all of these. Doesn't look like there's a cost difference between the two. Or with that one. Yep, they all cost the same. Just 10 interior plates, 20 construction components, and 20 computers. So pretty cheap, I think. It's been a while since I played Survival. Anyway. What the frick are you aiming at? Yeah. I'll have links for all four mods down in the description below. So you may play around with them to however you want. Like put the mailbox in your house for like roleplay sort of stuff. Or you can even place down the container in your ships to have a nice and fancy storage system. Or build a tower like this one. There's a fancy thruster to really give you a bit of a boost. And help it move through the stars with incredible speeds. I even place these little buttons on your small ships to give them more function in a more compact space. Because for some of these, you'll need like four. Wait. Yeah, the vanilla button panels for small ships only has one button. Meaning if you want to do the 12 one, you have to have 12 buttons scattered, which takes up a lot of space for a small ship. But this makes it a lot better. I think it's going to be one of the mods that I will keep installed and actually enhance some of my builds over there. Make them better. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe to episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.